Louisiana's sugarcane belt is expanding, and LSU AgCenter researchers are examining ways to reduce the environmental footprint of farming through a $1.4 million grant from the Patrick F. Taylor Foundation.
We're also monitoring water quality that's coming out of these fields, whether it's in best management practices or sort of farmer standard practices, so we can show the benefits from that as well, of reducing nutrients flowing out of the fields, reducing sediment that's coming out of the field.
Nitrogen fertilizer is essential to producing a good crop, but it's expensive and pollutes water when it leaves the farm. This project has shown Keith Duga ways to reduce both his nitrogen applications and cost.
Through the project, we learned where it really doesn't need all that nitrogen. And expensive like everything is these days, you need to try to cut back wherever you can where it won't hurt your yield.
After harvest, cane farmers burn the residue left in the field to help stimulate growth for next year. Duga has been sweeping the residue between the rows as an alternative to burning.
With burning, we have seen very short-term increases in things like nitrogen into the soil, but they don't last for very long, so they don't really support sustainable growth from that. So part of the goal of the sweeping is to reduce the need for burning to remove that residue.
Fultz said as the residue breaks down, it provides nutrients to the soil. Taylor Foundation representatives are pleased with the research and its potential for improving agriculture and the environment.
It is one of the most excited programs we have ever funded, and we plan to continue funding it because we have a deep interest in agriculture and the future of the state of Louisiana.
Researchers are hoping the findings generated from the study will become standard practices throughout the sugarcane industry. With the LSU AgCenter, this is Craig Gautreaux reporting.